Hello dear students and welcome back in our science session. So in our science session we are discussing our lesson that is what getting to know plant. So in that today we are going to discuss about the next point from the same lesson that we are going to discuss about modification of plant. What we are going to discuss? Modification of stems. Okay. So before going that, already we have discussed about the functions of a stem. So the main function of a stem is what? To give the support to the plant and also for the conduction. Conduction means what? It helps to transport the water from the, means the root absorbs the water and that absorbs water is gave, say to the stem, and with the help of the stem it gets transported to the different body part of the plants. Okay. Next one we can say that the plants, as we know, the leaf is preparing the food, so that prepared food is again get transported to the whole plant with the help of the stem. So it is what we can say, the conduction is there and also it gives the support to the plant. But along with that, there are the certain other functions are there which are performed by the stem, and for that we are calling as what? Modification of stem. But before going to these, we will conduct one activity that is given in your textbook, page number 59. So what is the aim of that activity? It is that to show that water rises through the stem. Okay, so what we have to prove is that with the help of the stem, the water goes up into the plant. For this activity, I have taken one these flower. Okay, so what is the color of this flower? White. Okay, as you see, the color of the flower is what? White. So this flower I will keep in this colorful water. Okay, this flower I will keep in this colorful water for the certain period of the time, and after that we will observe. Okay, so once we'll observe, we'll keep it for the long period of the time, we can see the flower. Okay, so here you can see the color of the petals somehow changed. Why it is changed? Because with the help of this stem, this colorful water goes into the flower, and that's why the shades of the or the petals border is get changed with the different color. Okay, so with the help of this, what we can say that the stem helps to rise up the water. So this is about the activity, we can say that. Now we will see the our main point, that is what? Modification of stem. So the first modification of the stem we are going to discuss, that is what? Storage of food. So as you know, in the root also we have seen that there are the certain roots which stores the food there. So that roots are called, that type of the roots are called as what? Storage root. Like that, there are the certain stems which are also storing the food in it, and that which are the roots which stores the food in it. For example, you can say that ginger, onion and potato. My dear students, keep in the mind, it is very important. Potato is stem while sweet potato is a root. Okay, so the potato is a underground stem, we can say that, and it stores the food, and that is the reason it is somehow bulky. Okay, so see, why we are calling them a ginger, onion and potato as a stem? Why they are not root, since they are growing under the ground? Because what is mean by the stem? The stem is having node on it or having the internode on it. Okay, so some like that, this ginger, onion and potato is also having the node on it, for them we are calling as what? Bud. Okay, in your previous class you have seen that the potato, on the potato there are the buds present, for that buds we are calling as what? Eyes also. So that is the reason the buds are present only on the stem, and that is the reason the ginger, onion and potato are the underground stem and they stores the food. So in the image you can see how it is exactly, this is what? Ginger. So the gingers are having the scaly leaves and also they are having what? Nodes on it. Next one we will discuss about what? Onion. See your onion. Okay, so onion is like this, and at the base, okay, so this is the structure of the onion. Now I will draw the diagram of the onion. See here, this is what? Onion. Okay, so at the end of the onion you can see the white color, this, that is only what? Stem of onion. And like this roots also you can say, so it is a which type of the root, and these are the roots. Okay, so these are which type of the roots? These are the fibrous roots. Okay, and inside it, it is having what? Bud, which helps for the new growth. Okay, and like this upside we can see the green leaves that we are eating also. So it is what? Green leaves. Okay, these are what? Green leaves. Also like these leaves are present on it, that one by one layer we are removing, that are called as what? Scaly leaves. Okay, upper side leaves are called as what? Scaly leaves. And the onion which we are eating, that what? The inner part of the onion we are eating, that are what? Storage leaves. Storage leaves. Okay, so somehow it is like this, a structure of onion. So where is the stem of the onion? Downside, the disc like shape is there, that is what? The stem of the onion. These are the fibrous root. It contains the inside bud. Next one, it is there what is what? Storage of the leaves. Next one, the scaly leaves that we are removing, and these are the green leaves which are upside. Okay, so that is the reason these all the things are present on the onion, and that is the reason it is what? Underground stain. Okay, it is what? Underground stain. Okay, so potatoes, in the image of the potato, potatoes are also having what? Buds on it, or we are calling as what? Eye. And that is the reason the potato is also the one type of the underground stem. Okay, so this is the first modification of the stem we are discussing, that is what? Storage of food. Now we will move for the next one, that is what? Food manufacture. Now food manufacture means what? As we know, who is the food factory or who is the kitchen of the plant? So green plants. So basically in all the plant food, food is get prepared for the whole plant by the leaves. But there are the certain plants which convert their stem, or their stems are thick, fleshy, and most important, green in color. And that is the reason the stem is performing the photosynthesis process. Okay, for example, we can say that what? Cactus. In the image, you can see what? Cactus. So, in the see the image of the cactus, how it is the stem. So, this structure you can see that this is what? Stem. Okay, and it is green in color, it is fleshy also, it is thick also, and that is the reason in the cactus the stem prepare their food for the plant. Then it means the cactus doesn't have the leaf. Yes, the cactus has the leaf. As we know, like this cactus is there, but all the cactus has the spines are there. Okay, so these spines are nothing but for leaves. These are the leaves of the cactus. Okay, these are called modified leaves. Why they are modified? Because as we know, the cactus mainly grows into the desert region, and in the desert region already there is a scarcity of the water. So with the help of this leaf, if the normal leaves will be there, then there will be the transpiration process. What is my transpiration process that we are going to see? Here I will tell you just one thing about the transpiration is what? Transpiration means the loss of water from the leaf. Okay, so already there is a lack of the water, and if again in that there will be the loss of the water, then it is not good for the plant. And that is the reason in the desert the leaves are getting converted into the spines. Okay, and the work of the photosynthesis is done by the green color stem, and this stem is what? Thick, fleshy, and most important is what? Green. Okay, so why we are telling this is the modification? Because the making of the food, it is not the work of the stem, it is the work of the plant, leaves we can say. But in some plants the stem is doing the photosynthesis process, and for that only we can call as what? Food manufacturing. That is one of the modification of the stem. And we in which plant we can see this type of the modification of the plant? In the cactus plant. Okay, now we look for the next modification, that is what? Defense. Now what is mean by defense? So as we know, if someone will comes over you, if the dog is coming over you, then what you will do? You will run away from that. Yes, why? To protect yourself. So like that, as we know, the plants are also living thing, they also need to protect themselves. Okay, so for the protection purpose, in the some plants, for example, we can say bougainvillea. You can see in the image bougainvillea plant. So in that bougainvillea, the bud is getting converted into the spine. Okay, so you can see in the image how the bud is getting exactly converted into the spines or the thorns. The bud is get converted into the spine or the thorns. Why? For the protection purpose. Because of the thorns in the spine, the animals will not eat that plant. and the plants will get protected from the animals. Okay, so in this way they are protecting themselves from the animals. So that is one small modification of the stem, that is what? Difference. Okay, so in that bird in the stem modified into spines or fronds. Okay, the bird which are present on the stem is get modified into the spines or the fronds. Okay, so these are the certain modifications of the stem that are storage of food, food manufacture and defense. Okay, so this is all about today. Today we have discussed about the manufactures of stem. Today we have discussed about the modifications of stem. Okay, so here we will stop. We'll meet in the next video with the next point and the new concept. And for today, thank you.